Rained a little bit more last night. Ooh, the FedEx guy's here. I feel like it would almost be a crime not to unbox this in front of you guys, you know? I guess this video turned into an unboxing. I know what it is. I told you guys I purchased that Xbox. I'm playing a couple video games here and there. I've been liking Rainbow Six Siege, Call of Duty, obviously. Been playing this pirate game. And Fortnite, obviously Fortnite. So, but it's hard to play without a headset, you know. For me, at least, I'm so used to listening, like where they are, and not having a headset, it's kind of tough. So I got a headset. I think it was only like 30 or 40. It was like 40, maybe. Yeah, I think it was like 40 bucks. Maybe 30, yeah, I think it was like 39 bucks, so I mean, we might as well check it out for you guys. If I was watching and somebody got a package and didn't open it, I'd be a little upset. Chinese tape. I'll probably cut some of this out. This thing. There we go. She's coming. There we go. There we go. I didn't realize the mic did that. That's sick. Okay. It's got this cool little headband here. I just got them because, I don't know, they just looked real quality, you know? Oh, yeah, they are. Oh, shit. Did I turn it on? New. Ooh, that's nice little swivel action. All right. That's enough fucking around with these. I'm gonna get some butts up. As cool as these are, can't play with them until I'm done playing.
Come on, I'll cut some of this.
I'll be back. Look who came. Okay.
I love you. Bye.
I'm back. I had to show my girl. You know, the headset. It's actually really nice for like a cheaper. For a cheaper headset. It's not bad. Blueberry. Probably one of my favorite flavors. it really depends if it's like. This one hits pretty year-round, but like if it's seasonal, you know, like if it's strawberry season, then the strawberry flavor goes crazy. It's so sweet, so good. Let me make sure I'm still rolling. All right, we rolling.
You see how I set up two baskets? You know, I can just put it any of them in, and you guys don't even know which one. I just gotta throw it up.
Put it right between them every time, that'd be awesome. I'm trying to start doing more high quality practice, you know. Just keep it to nothing but high quality practice. Let me get that a couple of things in the mix. You guys can't really tell, but I've been throwing so much in this garage, just kind of getting that, you know, that good form, that good form dialed back in. Two, pop, you know, make sure I'm keeping that disc in that nice straight line. It's literally shaving. I'm like shaving the concrete down. I'm like, I got a smooth spot, and I gotta like sand it out every so often because it's shaving it down. I'm not sure if it's just a shaving concrete or what, but
jammed the small one but missed the big one. Some bullshit. There we go.
Come deep over here. Do a smiley face on the bottom of my wizards. Just to let myself know and to keep on smiling. You know? My dad was a paramedic for 20 years, you know? Ain't nobody dying in this profession, okay? You could be sad over there because people are dying. Over here, we're just throwing frisbees, you know? I mean, yeah, I'm giving my life to it, but at the end of the day, we're all still alive, you know? Getting it back here. I like that release point a little higher. Sport mode. That's really my problem. Can't expect to get shit done without sports mode on your fucking Crocs. Man, there was this one kid the other weekend when I was playing football. He literally, he's got this like Fabio hair. Like, just beautiful locks, dude, curly. But he, I loved his putt because every time, he didn't miss a lot, but every time he would miss, I swear to God, his next putt would be like harder, more committed, more, just more. Instead of being like scared after he missed, he would get pissed and just go jam it. I'm like, man, that's what I used to do. I used to get fucking just angry. So angry to the point where I'm like, I'm just gonna go fucking slam that next one. And so I kind of took a page out of that book. You know, stop feeling sorry for myself and start just fucking getting angry and just fucking go. You know, use some of that anger as a motivator, you know. And jam that shit for that next one. But still stick to that good routine, you know. Feeling pretty good. I'm sick of this skin right here. Oh, I remember what it was from. I was like using this. I was trying to make French fries in this like chopper push down thing, but it like wouldn't get it because it was too long. And I like started pushing it, and it just so it's been peeling after healing ever since. All right, we're good now. Ooh, count it. I count those. You got to.
Shout out my mom if you're watching this. I love you. And my dad. I love you too, though. Find out how to get that nice clean grease point, just hot. It's a little higher, you know. Sometimes it gets a little wonky when I get a little higher. Just get that nice clean grease point in. Just a little higher. I committed to that one. You always tell when I commit when I just kick everything behind me. Door, boxes, whatever. Hey, we got one more skinny basket. Pretty sore today.
See if you guys are still good. All right, we're still good.
Probably gonna go on a, you know, nothing too crazy. My core, my back, everything's pretty sore. I've been doing a lot of rotational core work and running and legs, like just sprints. I sprint up this driveway, it's real steep. So I'm gonna light jog just around the block today. And then come back, maybe go get some dinner, see what the deal is with dinner, and then cook some dinner, get another putt sesh before dinner or after my run, maybe, and then go play some video games right before one more putt sesh, though. Just quick, you know, like 15, 30 minutes. The later it gets, the quicker they get, you know. you guys are still
rolling. Rolling, rolling. We're still rolling.
The biggest tell sign for a good putt for me is if I break like with my elbow real hard, or if I just kind of like fluidly come up in one motion. I can feel it. It's like I'm like breaking it and then trying to catch up. I wish I could just like feel my elbow start to break and just stop. But you can only just practice, try not to do it. Just work. Not try not to do it, but try to just do the right thing. That's all you can. Alright, I think for the challenge today, we're going 2 from short, 2 from medium, and then we're going to hit 2 from long. So we're going to go 1 short, 1, so we got 4 on the front, so we're going to go boom, 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 and then we're going to go boom, boom, and then boom, boom again, and then we're done. For the first session. Love you too. Missing an easy one. Hit the easy one. Hit the easy one. Done missing love. I hate missing love. Just stop missing love. It's not hard. It's not hard to do. You just gotta double it up, you know? It's that easy. Fucking throw it hard. And then boom, you won't miss love. Throw it up. Thank you. is starting to get a little windy. Makes the challenge a little bit harder.
Don't matter though. We're gonna get it done.
basket is 20 feet long. Get it in the air. All you have to do is throw it up. God damn, dude. Get that out here too long.
Fuck you, dude. Lock it in. Lock it the fuck in. Challenge might have been over already if I wasn't playing on two of the worst fucking catching baskets known to man. I mean, right behind the veterans. Sorry, right behind the veterans. Veterans suck. Any veteran basket sucks ass. Like all the dynamic baskets, they suck so bad. Like how do you produce a basket that sucks? Like we got good baskets out there. It's crazy. And it's the easiest fix ever too. It's like it took me 1 year, I think, of being on the road and seeing the different baskets and seeing why the dynamic basket sucks. It's because of the bottom ring. The bottom ring on every basket except for the dynamic basket is pretty much, like, let's say this is the pole for the basket, right? Every ring is pretty much like, almost like just like, it's got a little wiggle, you know, not much. But the dynamic one has like 3 inches wide on each side. So it sways back and forth, like even in like heavy wind rounds, their chains are literally moving back. It's the worst. It is the worst. All they have to do is take that big ring and make it smaller. Great basket. Fantastic.
But it's just that one thing.
Thank you.
still recording. I've been doing this for a while.
Been recording for a while. Nope. Oh, okay, okay. Just a low battery percent. We're at 20%. We're gonna get this. I don't give up on my camera now.
My phone might die and I might get the challenge later, but I ain't giving up on it. Extra close, give myself a little bit more.
perfect timing on this. I literally looked at it go. I literally looked at the 10% mark pop up. I was crazy. Nah, we're getting it done. 10% left. We're getting it done.
Baskets are just a little too unpredictable. Makes this challenge a lot harder than it should be.
Story of my fucking life today.
Story of my fucking life, dude. Jesus fuck, dude.
Oh, dude. Fucking finally. Fucking sick of this fucking challenge. Fuck this fucking bullshit. Fucking finito. Fuck you guys. Fucking shout out fucking Gateway. Fuck.
Fuck you. Fuck this shit. Fucking out of here.